That was a conversation we had. I'm going to make you a household name. I'm like, all right, that's, I take your word for it, but bro, that's a hard thing to do. Like a household name, I can't go nowhere. I went and got a car from Enterprise. My man came out, no. I was like, yes, I'm not robbing the store. I just want a car. He was like, E.T., you changed my life, bruh. Manager came out, E.T., I came back today late. I didn't even get to put the gas in the whip. I'm like, I got to go. My man was like, gas, E, that's, give me the, it's easy. They won't even know it wasn't full when you got here. That's easy, E. Are you hearing me? I'm a household name. I'm a household name. So Oprah Winfrey Network, we were sitting down coming up with a show, and they were asking me, like, who's your demographic? And I told them who? Everybody. So I can't get a show because they can't believe that I can get it. They like, no, young African-Americans. I was like, no, if you look at my algorithms, my followers are white males between the age of 25 and 35. That's my biggest following, not black men from Detroit. They can't understand that. They don't get it. I'm walking through the airport. I've got people old, young, the whole nine following me. And the networks are like, but you got to have. I'm like, I'm not on that. I gave my stuff to everybody. So guess what? Everybody's blessing me now. And so write down real quick for me what assets you have that you could give away right now. I want you to think about that. What assets do you have right now at your age with your skill set? What assets do you have right now that you know you could give away? What knowledge base do you have right now? What skill set that you like right now, I can add value right now. That's the name of the game. Before I let you go, listen to me. The name of the game is if you can add value, they're going to keep you around. If I pick you up and every time I pick you up, I got to take you out to eat. You don't ever have no money. When I'm starting to cut people off, you the first one to go. I'm like, oh, yeah, ooh, that's going to save me $50 right there. If every time I call you, you got some drama, I can let you go. I'm just being real. But if you're the type of friend, this is the type of relationship that I can't let Sean go. I want to let him go. I can't let him go. He might want to let me go. He can't let me go. We add too much value to each other's life to be let go on. We can't do it. So I need you to stop starting with money. Stop starting with what can I get? And I need you as an employee, I need you to say, I'm going to add so much value to this company. I'm going to add so much value to these individuals. I'm going to add so much value in terms of the time that I put forth at this job that they couldn't fire me if they wanted to. And if they fired me, somebody else would gladly pick me up. All right? So CJ make it up in his mind. I'm not going to speak. I'm not going to take these jobs. I'm just going to blow Eric Thomas up. And CJ made me into a household name. And guess what? By CJ making me into a household name, CJ said, I only got one job. If people ask me on my resume, what do? I blew ET up. But right now, CJ is living in a beautiful 5-6-bedroom house in Atlanta with a big pool in the back and living his dreams. Matter of fact, his kids went to Disney World 2 weeks ago, and now with some of our higher-up guys, they all at Orlando again 2 weeks later. He's living a life. And guess what he does for a living? He helps other individuals, he brand other individuals, and he's trying to help them become number one in their industry. So by him helping me become number one, he found out how to make somebody number one. Now he gets paid to make people number one. So he did me speaking, he did Toby in music, and now he like, anybody that need to blow up, I can help you blow up. So he actually started his own career and became an entrepreneur by helping me and not helping himself. Good. What did you write down? What are the values you guys have that you can give away? What are the values? What did you write down?
Skill development.
Good. Skill development. Leadership. Good. What else do we have?
Networking.
Networking. You can teach people how to network. Good. What else do we have?
Inspire.
Good. You can inspire. You right. What up? What up? What up? It's your boy, E.T. My mom like, what are you doing? I'm inspiring, Ma. Go get a real job. This is a real job, Ma. It's a real job right here. It's like, YouTube don't pay you. I said, just wait. And now my mind works for me. All right? I love it. Inspiring. What else do we have? Talk to me. What value are we going to add?
Sales.
Yep. Love it. Everything is sales. Everything is sales. Absolutely. What else do we have, guys?
Work ethic.
Good. How old are you?
29.
Especially in this generation, work ethic is, whoa, because they not really own that like that. Good. I love it. What else do we have? Good, showing people efficient ways, not just being active, but getting results, executing. Good, what else do we have? How to stay with it. You don't blow up. I didn't blow up the first year, second year, third year. It's about 4 or 5 years into it that people start good. Consistency. What else do we have? Good. Discipline. Good. People make 50, 60 million playing a sport and lose 50, 60 million. Not discipline. So it's easy to get it. It's hard to sustain it. Good. Talk to me. What else do we have?
Motivation.
Good. Good. Critical thinking. Decision making. That's so important. We talked about that the other day with our company. It's like, do I have to generate funds? It's not about generating money. It's about making good decisions. And then when you are a strategist, when you go from playing checkers to chess, and you can think 4 or 5 moves ahead, they pay you for that. Good. Talk to me. Anything else we got? I know I got to let y'all go. Anything else before y'all get out of here?
Creativity.
Good. Not just thinking in the box, thinking outside the box, making stuff that wasn't there before. Good. I love it. Good. I love it. I tell people all the time, Carl took me to the TGIM level. And I remember Carl, I remember him just saying like, yo, E, bro, I don't know what I was doing. I don't know what else to do. I'm like, all right, love you. You out. Nikki, come in. Nikki took me number one. People like E.T., you all over the place. Not really. Social media. I was at home. I'm just being real. Like this dude called me today. E, you in New York? I'm like, nope. You are New York. I said, I'm not in New York. You are. I said, bro, I can't keep telling you over and over again. I'm in Detroit right now. He's like, but the video. I was like, that's Nikki. Call Nikki. She got it looking like I'm in New York. I'm in Detroit right now with my wife. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But that's that creativity. That's that coming up with. And guess what? If I wanted to fire, I couldn't fire right now if I wanted to fire. She done made herself so valuable that I can't. A lot of you, the way you're working right now, you're disposable. I'm just being clear. Y'all got to go. I'm letting you go, but I'm just being honest. The way some of you work, you're disposable. With what you do, I can replace you. I can replace you. I can get somebody else to do what you're doing, especially if we're paying people. If I got to pay for that, I can pay somebody else to do that. Matter of fact, I can hire somebody else new and not give them as much as I'm giving you because you've been here so long, and I can give them less for what you're doing. You're disposable. Now, I don't know who you are because I don't know you. He didn't give me no names, but somebody out of the group, you're disposable. I can let you go. You can't get rid of me if you wanted to. People wake up to my stuff every day. You think CP3 called me because I'm cool? I add value. Guess how much I charged them? How much? Oh, no, I was asking you. I asked you. You asking me. That's smart, though. That's some political stuff right there. You asked them a question, they asked you a question. That's some political stuff. She's smart. She's a critical thinker. Good. How much did I charge him?
For a week? Or how long?
Yeah, well, we were in L.A. I did his leadership camp in L.A. Then we flew to Winston. I did that for him yesterday, so for 2 days.
500 grand.
Yeah, I should. Wow, I love it. Yeah. No. I'm worth that much. I'm undervaluing myself. How much should I charge him?
Half that.
That's good. 20,000. Good. How much? Nothing. I always start every relationship by doing what? Adding what? Adding value. So when you go, this next week coming up, Monday, I need you to add value. All right, so you're asking what those other two are because I know we got to go. So we said, what do you want? What does it take to get what you want? What do you have to sacrifice? What do you have to sacrifice in that third corner at the bottom left? What do you have to sacrifice? And then the last one, gratitude. The last one, gratitude. Always speaking about what you're grateful for and not what you don't have. All right? Good. All right. I know they got to get out of here. Oh, yes, guys. Yes. Where? Okay, so here's how we're going to add value. Where are my inspirers and motivators? Raise your hand again. All right, now look, we just, unfortunately, we live in a real world. Stuff happens. We just lost 2 staff members, right? So those of us who are inspirers, this is where we come to life. That's what I always tell people. It's like everybody loves the sun, but can you stand the rain? Right? And so when the rain comes, I actually like the rain because I'm a motivator. I actually like the rain because when it rains, my gift gets to come out. Most people, when death or devastation or destruction happens, they kind of go, they're introvert, and they kind of go in and they reflecting and can't really operate at the high. It is actually inspire us. This is the time where we show up. This is the time that we become creative. And this is the time we pull each other. All right, so listen to me. I want y'all to know this is the truth. If you remember when I blew up, does anybody remember when my videos, what was happening in the earth in the world when my videos blew up? You know what time it, you remember what? what season it was in the world? We were in a depression. We were in a depression. Detroit, the 3-4 Jim Chrysler went down, and I told Carl, go get the camera. It's showtime. We're in a depression right now. Let's go. My videos blew up. My videos are blowing up now. I'm not saying right or wrong. President of the United States of America, President Trump. I'm not saying, look, I'm not into Republican, Democrat. I ain't into none of that. But right now, just being honest with the way things are going, with the way our president leads right now, that's just what's going on in the world right now. Let's be real. What's going on in the world right now? It's tension, right? It's tension. While a lot of people look at that as bad, for me and my company, that's what? That's good. It's opportunity. Because if you feel stressed out right now, either way, you're going to go do what? You're looking for what? You're looking for inspiration. You're looking for guidance. So you go check ET out, right? So I'm going to be honest with y'all. If the world was like Coca-Cola, everybody raise their hand, we just loving each other, you might not go to me and watch Motivate. You might not need it. But right now, when Barack was there, a lot of tension. Right now, President Trump, it's a lot of tension. And so people are coming to ET because it's tension. So I'm trying to tell you what's happening right now. While it is terrible, it's showtime. It's time for the inspirers to inspire. It's time for y'all to get the cards, play the music, use your tongue, smile. It's time, y'all. And so this is not a time for us to go, man, what's happening? No, it's time to say, this is what's about to happen. And not only that, based on what's happening, we're going to do our research, and we're going to try to make sure that that doesn't what? Because we know the leading cause of death is what? Stress. We understand that. That is the leading cause of death in the United States of America right now. It's not AIDS. It's not gun violence. It is death. I mean, stress. It's stroke, folks stroking out. I just told you, Dan Gilbert, he just had a stroke. He just had a stroke. He owned 51 companies. Something was going wrong. He had a stroke. I called. It's like, we showed him the video, but he can't see nobody right now. So that's not a good sign. Right? So it's a lot of us in the room stressed out, right? As an inspirers, we need to make sure we address that. We need to make sure we move around. Some of us are not at our peak in terms of our health, and it don't have nothing to do with big or small, right? It's some people who small who not healthy, right? But we're talking about mental health, which is a big topic right now. We're talking about emotional health, and we need to be there for one another. We can't keep coming to work faking it like ain't nothing going on at home. It's some stuff going on at home. It's some drama going on at home. And we need to address that. I'm a grown man, but I got kids. Anytime you got kids, it's drama. If I got kids, I got grown kids, right? So my daughter trying to baby date. I'm like, can you just give me a year? I'm at peace right now. Don't bring nobody into our life right now. Ain't no dating. Because if something go wrong with homeboy, I got to be the one. She's like, why are you tripping on my relationship? Because if he break up with you or do something, guess who you calling? You calling daddy. And I got to go on campus. I got to go on campus. You know what I'm saying? You done messed up my whole career because I can't act like I don't see it. I got to go up there and talk to my man. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So let's inspire us, mount up. Inspire us, let's go. Let's do the cards, the gift cards, right? Let's start sending the links. Let's start doing groups, chats, and start sending all the inspiring stuff. All right, so let's do what we got to do. Guys, I know you got to get back on the floor. Do me a favor. When you go back and work like you've never worked before. All right, get out of survival mode. Let's get to striving. And once you get past striving, let's get to thriving. And there's a whole world, I can tell you, it's a whole world waiting for you. But it's not going to come to you. You got to go get it. All right, thank you guys so much. Harvard, stay with us. Harvard, stay with us. Thank you. Thank you. I'm gonna need you to be real. Some of this stuff's gonna hurt today, but it's okay. One of the things I'm starting to realize is there's a small group of people that's really living the American dream. So they're selling you some good information. They're not showing you how to execute on those. All I'm saying is, as we move forward, we can't help certain things, but we're not gonna sabotage ourselves. I'm gonna show you why they execute and why you don't. But more of us could be living whatever life we want. But what they didn't show you is how you were supposed to do that. What I want y'all to start doing for me is having dreams and then give me a couple nightmares to go with the dreams. For real, I just want you to make up in your mind like this could happen. Not because I want you to be spooked out, but I don't want you to get hit and you like, I didn't prepare for that.